Anoma, welcome to the stream. How are you doing today, friend? Ads are taking over. All right. Hello, Jello. I hope that your work day is going okay. Thank you, Luma, for confirming as per usual. Let's get this file open. Busy all day. Yeah, I believe it. So this file is absolutely, it's pretty massive. So the program may lag at times. It's not necessarily Twitch or your guys' internet. It's just, it's a big file. Canvas size is 5,000 by 6,000 pixels. So it's big. It's a big file. I opened up the sketch earlier and it's a big file. So just be prepared in case there's any lag. It's not necessarily your guys' fault. It's just Metabang is trying its best to keep up with the file and is Hey, Easy. Type up a response since apparently they can't hear me. Hope the program doesn't crash. Yeah, we're gonna hope that doesn't happen. So I guess the biggest thing is that I'm gonna need to remember to just save very often. That way. Metabang does not crash often. The only time I've ever had it crash on me was because I had an old phone that was very, very full of files and I needed to clear some space out. That's really the only time I've had it crash on me. Generally, like on my laptop, no, I don't have it crash on me. Control plus S is my friend. Yes it is. So I'm gonna do this commission kind of like the same way that I did the first prize illustration for Easy, where I work on the character first and then get into the background. It crashed on screen. Did it crash on stream? I don't think I've had it crash on me. I've had it freeze for a couple seconds before, but I don't think I've had it crash. And it's a Luna making an early appearance. Hello, Luna. Hello, Miss Princess. Miss Una with the waggly tail. How are you doing, silly puppy? Where's your brother? What's your brother up to? Huh? What's your brother up to? So this is the background. And this is just the sketch, but I kind of came up with this myself, because I wasn't really given a background suggestion, but this sort of thing just kind of came to mind, and so I proposed it as a suggestion, and, they ended up liking it, so... You know, I'm actually pretty happy with how it looks, honestly. Yeah, that's just a sketch. That was just the sketch, and I went a little crazy on the sketch because I really wanted to convey exactly what I had in mind, and just make sure that, like, he knew exactly what I had in mind, so I could get a definitive approval for it, because I don't like to be vague about what I have in mind, just because there can be some easy misconceptions, and I want to make sure that they understand like exactly what I have in mind, just that way I know exactly what I'll be doing for each step and whatnot. But yeah, I'm glad that you like it though, Luma, and I'm kind of wanting to play doing art styles kind of like this, where it's not like 100% clean lines and whatnot, and just kind of see what I can do with that. See if I can play more with like something more conceptual looking as compared to like a clean finished piece, because sometimes I don't have the energy for that, and I feel like if I do it more of a conceptual, then I can at least get a good image done without having to worry about it looking like super clean. So that might be something I play around with in the future, but it'll be something to think about. Now the early sketch stage for this was actually very, very different looking, and the very first like sketch layout that I sent was pretty much literally a scribble, and let me pull it up here actually, because just so I can show you like exactly how I started with this one, because it's actually kind of funny to me in a way. So like here we have like what I sent for approval, but literally started out like this. This is literally how the sketch started. And I know it's hard to see because the lines are so thin. But this was what I originally started with. Was literally just this really, really extremely simple sketch, and just to kind of like get an idea for like the framing of the composition, and obviously it's changed somewhat, mostly the sizing of the character and obviously the sizing of the canvas. But that turned into this. So there's a lot that goes into my thought process that y'all don't necessarily see. So I just kind of wanted to show you guys where that one started, because it it initially started as something extremely simplistic. And I'm really happy with how the final layout ended up turning out. But it'll be more interesting to see how it turns out as a finished project. How much for this masterpiece? Yeah. Yeah, normally, so I haven't really done a lot of commissions like this so far. I mean, the last like full illustration piece that I did, it's been a while, honestly. I did do a commission for somebody that I met from a Pokemon Go group, and he had wanted me to draw him and his wife together with their favorite shiny Pokemon, and that one was... That was quite a project, honestly. Let's see, here it is. So this was a while back, but this was another commission that I did for somebody. The one that I was just talking about right now, where I drew him and his wife. And his favorite Pokemon is Ninetales and Vulpix. So he wanted himself drawn with shiny versions of them, and then his wife with a shiny Magikarp and Gyarados. And this one took a while, that was a while back. But until I started doing these full illustration ones, that was kind of the only, like, main, like, really big, fully illustrated images that I had done. Until now, obviously, where I've done quite a few. I do like where my art has been going, so I'm looking forward to seeing some other projects in the future. I should do commissions for backgrounds. I mean, I probably could, but I don't know. I don't usually enjoy doing backgrounds. And most of the time, if I do a background, it's mostly because I have to and not because I want to. And I don't really have a lot of confidence in my background skills quite yet. So I don't know if I will be offering commissions for that anytime soon. I'm honestly horrible with names. You'll have to explain that. You'll have to explain that one to me. I'll probably feel dumb when I hear it. It'll be something like really obvious. Two kinds artist. Yeah, if he's really good at backgrounds, then I definitely cannot be compared to that guy, because I do not have that level of confidence in my backgrounds yet, anyways. Oh, I mean, down the road, yeah, maybe, but anytime soon is not gonna happen. Comics, honestly, are a really good way to get better at drawing. I mean, between getting better at drawing characters, you also get really good at drawing expressions. And then, you know, composition learning and backgrounds and whatnot. That's partly why I've been enjoying doing the comic pages for Chime, because it's really good practice overall. Any progress is that is 100,000% true, Luma. That is so true. You are very correct on that. Any progress is progress. Absolutely correct. Yeah, sometimes I look at my art and I'll be like, oh man, you know, I'm not really where I want to be, you know, and it's like, but look at what you're doing now compared to even like a couple years ago, you know. I still have some of my really old stuff saved on my laptop. And occasionally I'll look at them and it's just like, oh my gosh, like totally different than what I'm doing now. And it's kind of crazy to see where you're at as compared to before. And save. Yeah, I don't typically erase my stuff if I can avoid it, especially for like stuff like that. It's good to kind of like be able to compare it and see what you were at before versus now. And I don't have anything particularly super old on this laptop. A lot of my older stuff is on my old laptop that takes 100 years to open. and startup. But like, let me see. Don't know what year this is, but this is one that I did a while back. This was probably like when I was in high school, so anywhere between like 2007 and 2011. So I mean, it's pretty old. This is when I still used to use Photoshop to draw in. But yeah, this is pretty old. And it's not horrible, but it's definitely a big jump from where I'm at now in comparison. Well, thank you, Luma. Yeah, the character in that drawing is actually one of my oldest OCs, and I'm still very fond of him. And I keep meaning to do like some updated art of him because it's been so long, but I just haven't really done that yet. So for those of you here right now, just to give you guys a heads up, I probably won't be streaming next week, Wednesday or Saturday, just because, Wednesday I'm going to a viewing for my uncle who passed away, and then, that following Sunday is my birthday, so it's gonna be kind of a crazy week next week, and then This Saturday I will be streaming. I should be streaming this Saturday unless something else comes up, but I will let you guys know if anything like that happens. So as far as I know, this Saturday I am still streaming, but just next week I likely will not be. Oh, I was telling Thor to be quiet, so I muted myself for that. But, Thor is a boof. Well, it's definitely a good way to practice drawing, for sure. Yeah, that definitely helps. Like, they have those pens with, like, the rubber tips that you can use, but I hate those because the rubber tips are just so big that it makes it hard to be precise. And that was the reason I got my Note 9. Yeah, they're entirely different, and that was kind of why I had been so, like, adamant about getting a note, because it came with a pen, and the nib of the pen is very small and really helps with being able to do precise work with it, which you really don't get with those other ones. Just like completely different quality. Doing chime from memory. I mean, luckily he's pretty simple. Honestly, when I draw him now, he's kind of heavily, the way that I draw him now versus like his original design, I've very, very much took a lot of inspiration from Kirby. Because shape-wise, they're very similar. So I do use Kirby for reference for Chime. Because that just of how similar they are in like shape and design. Hey, Viper. So it's still me. I have a new look sometimes. This one actually debuted on April 1st as an April Fool's joke, but I liked it a lot. So viewers do have the option of changing between kitty and doggy form using prints. And last stream, Jello actually used their points to change it. It's still me. Viper, I had posted the raffle prize that I did for you on Tumblr, and it's been getting some notes recently. I had some people reblog it today. I'm doing all right, Viper. Thank you for asking. I was saying earlier though that I probably won't be streaming next week. Because my uncle's funeral and viewing are next week, and then next Sunday, so a week from this Sunday, that will be my birthday, so. I do think my Tumblr is linked on my page, Viper. I did post it fairly recently. So it is there for you to see if you would like. Although my Tumblr username is the same as this one, so you could even just like look me up on there. Under Dusk V Art. And saving again, just because I'm paranoid and this is a ginormous file size. Oh, looks like Luma just shared the link. I mean, I did send you the image on Discord when I finished it on stream, and I never heard back from you, so I was like, Viper's probably just busy. Still hate drawing hands, they're evil. Yeah, no worries. I mean, I knew you were out of town for the wedding, so like I wasn't like stressing about it or anything. But I had somebody comment on the drawing of your beardy, and let me pull up the comment real quick so I can read it because it made me happy. So somebody with the username Astra the Dragon responded to the post and said that I captured the scaled pancake gremlin essence of the species very well. And that made me happy because I love beardies, but the fact I was able to draw one very convincingly, not just to myself, but like to other people looking at the drawing, it made me happy. So I was like, the signature side eye, right? every beardy has that skill. Good old beardies. Definitely love bearded dragons. They're just very, very full of personality and very entertaining. I am very proud of that one though. Very, very happy with how it turned out. Maybe one day I will try drawing Noodle. Haven't tried drawing her yet, but perhaps one day. drawing clothing is a pain in the ass. Who knows how fabric folds work? It's not me. I'm trying my best though. I'm like, I don't care if I'm accurate so long as I'm believable. If you can tell that it's clothing, then as far as I'm concerned, I succeeded. Do I try to be accurate? Yes. Am I always successful? Absolutely not. What direction that went in. Where did it go? There it is. How's your day going so far, Viper? Better than yesterday. Well, I mean, that's a good thing, right? Well, that's good. Finished. Yes, I absolutely want you to send it so I can love it. And saving again because I'm paranoid. It is saving, and it's taking a while because it's a big file, and I didn't mean to rhyme, but that's just what happened. Okay, so first of all, that is spot on. You totally got him right. So props to you for that, but also that's freaking adorable. And I am saving that. And it is now saved, so I can admire it forever. Like when people draw my characters, because I like, one, it's really cool that you guys even want to do that, but like I also love seeing them in other styles aside from my own, so it's just really cool. And it brings me much joy. Ooh, he sends a transparent version too. Nice. So Luma, I know you don't play Pokemon Go like super often, and honestly, I don't play it like super often myself anymore, unless there's like a big event going on. But did you get to do the Cleaver raids that they did recently? I was hoping to get a shiny, but I didn't. But that's okay. I got 4 Cleaver from those raids, and I can't really complain about that. They were all 2 stars. I was hoping for at least 1 3-star. The multi-window feature comes in hand. Yeah, I like that my phone can do that too. And it's nice because I can like watch an anime or something while I'm working on art, which is good because my attention span tends to jump all over the place if I don't do that. So it kind of helps me focus on my art. Not much time to go to gyms. Yeah, honestly, that's totally valid. I don't really get to do them a whole lot myself. I do hate that they added a limit to how many remote raids that you can do, which in my opinion is really kind of dumb. Because it's like, what about people that can't really, like, leave their house? So I think that's a dumb change that they made. I mean, I don't really watch anything on YouTube to begin with, just because I hate all the ads. But it is nice when you can watch something while you're working on something. And I was like, nope, I'm not paying for that. Strong pass. If I like something, then yes, I will pay for it, but I do not like YouTube enough to be doing stuff like that, so I miss the old days where YouTube wasn't plagued by 100 billion ads that you could actually watch stuff. I also miss the days where you could like let a video buffer for 5 minutes and it would load the whole thing, and then you could just like watch it without having to worry about it constantly buffering. And I'm very sad that it's not like that anymore. I do miss that. Thank you. My week, it's pretty okay. Tomorrow we're gonna be going out and doing stuff. But for the most part, it's been pretty quiet, I think. I've been trying again to, like, get more into writing again, and I did finish a chapter today, which I was kind of proud of myself for, because writing has gotten kind of hard for me the last few years, and I haven't really been able to get myself to write much. But I got a chapter done today, so I think that's a pretty good improvement for myself, considering. Ooh, yeah, that's rough. You are stronger than I am. I hate getting up. Like, if I have to get up before 8, I am absolutely miserable. You bought 6 20-liter water bottles, like, oh, yeah. Yeah, that'll do it. Those things aren't light. They are pretty heavy. I remember when we used to have to buy those. They can definitely be hard to carry. Sometimes I forget I can rotate the canvas, and I'm very glad that I can because it comes in handy. Oh yeah, no. I accidentally tilt the canvas on Metabang quite often without meaning to, and I hate when I do that, but when I am doing it on purpose, then it's actually really handy. Because sometimes drawing lines at a certain angle is not the easiest, so when you rotate the canvas, it can make it a little bit easier. So I do like being able to do that at least. We're going for the green. Alrighty, let's see. Alright, how's this? when you guys pick a color, I try to get it to where the majority is the one that you guys requested. Thank you. And yet, sadly, I have never actually played any of those games. Well, at least I'm not alone in that. Well, get home safely. Watch out for the dum-dums out there. Because sadly, there are a lot of them. So many brushes. It's probably a good thing I stream on Wednesdays and not Thursdays, because apparently tomorrow MetaBang is doing a server update. So I wouldn't be able to access any online features, including accessing this file, which is up in the cloud. As intrigued as I am to play it, I haven't even finished the first one, so it probably wouldn't be a good idea for me to even get the second one. I don't even know if I'm gonna keep that. I'm right there with you, though, on not really being able to get it. I have the first one. I tried playing it, but I'm very intimidated by it. But I got it. I think I pre-ordered it when it first came out. I haven't beaten it. Because I just find it very intimidating. I do think it's a very pretty game. The graphics are stunning. I just a little too open for me, and that makes it a little hard. I think one day I'll just like bite the bullet and just like try and play it as best as I can. But some people are just really, really good at that game, and I am definitely not on that level. They get really, really crafty with stuff, and I'm like, I'm not. I'm not quite that brilliant when it comes to that sort of deal. Well, that's good to know if I ever get that far. part's gonna be doing those wings. Yeah, and this isn't actually nearly as detailed as the reference I was given for this character. So this is what I was actually given. For the reference. So I actually kind of simplified it a bit. But yeah. Dragonfly wings are very ornate. Because I haven't in a bit. All right, let's try this. You probably have no idea what I'm talking about, but I just made a brush. There you go, brush. It's one thing that I like about Metabang is being able to create my own brushes. I mean, kind of, but it's more just so, like, I can do a circle pattern. Although it seems to have moved itself. Where did you go? Hold on. Feel when you lose your brush. Where did you go? I lost my brush. There's so many here, I don't know where it went. Yeah. Where the heck did you go? Answer is yes and no. On the laptop version, yes. On the mobile version, no. And I just haven't made folders yet, and I keep meaning to, I haven't. Is that it? Did I find it? I did! There it is! I found you, finally. There we go. Yeah, no, I need to, but I figured you guys don't exactly want to sit here and watch me do that in stream. Because it will be a very long and tedious procedure. Do it? You want me to do it right now in stream? Folder stream, please. I mean, I can do that. All right. You win, Luma. it is something that I've needed to do. Let's see. I was using you for a project. You. Alrighty. So real quick, I'm gonna close this file just because it's big and it's gonna cause some lag. But I will have to test some of these brushes as I sort them just to, figure out exactly what they are. Yeah, it's saving. And then I'm just going to create a regular sized file, just, what is this? Interesting. I don't know what I would use that for, but, yeah. Hey Delta, Luma has persuaded me to start sorting my brushes into folders because I have a lot of them and it makes it hard to go through them all to look for something specific. Right. Exactly. Luma's speaking the truth. Oh, jeez. I don't think that's gonna happen, but you will get to see some cool brushes, though, that are available. Kind of wish that the folders didn't open every time you put something into it. It's a little annoying. Well, I'm glad you think so, Luma. This isn't exactly what I expected to be doing, but no complaints. I can at least do a little bit. Well, I'll stop here for now. But we made some pretty good headway, I think. So I'll take it. Yeah. Yeah, definitely made some headway. Continue it later. How many brushes does Metabang have? Yes. That's not a number. Yes. There's just that many. It is nice to have all that availability though, because a lot of them have helped me with some stuff. Especially with like chains and stuff like that. It's very helpful. The nice thing is I only have to do this half. I only have to do this half, and then I can just duplicate it and copy it. Which is what I actually did for the original sketch. Just because it helps save on time. And it certainly beats having to do it all over again, especially when something might not line up doing it by hand. So it just makes things a little bit easier. How do I keep the full image in my head when just working on one part? I think because I spend so much time on this sketch, it kind of just sticks. Because there's like a lot that you have to kind of consider when making it to begin with. Had the detour? Bad traffic or what? Oh. Well, that's unfortunate. I mean, I'm sorry to hear that happened to begin with, but... Oh, yeah, that's definitely a no bueno situation. That's a give me my money or a better... scooter, because we're gonna have problems otherwise. I mean, it's good they're replacing it, but it kind of sucks you have to wait a week before it's gonna show up. A manufacturing defect? Okay, well, that kind of makes it worse in a way, because it's like, why was this not checked out before it was, you know, sent out as a product? The battery. Okay, well, they should have been checking that. Jeez. A known bug and they didn't even catch them all. That's fantastic. And yeah, we knew about it, but we didn't make sure that we checked the product before sending out for purchase. You know, like what would make sense. Yeah, seriously.
Thank you.
saving as requested by Luma. Yeah, they were definitely on the detailed side. But now I just gotta delete that's the stuff that's crossing into the character themselves. I will save as soon as I finish erasing this that I don't need. Alright, now I will save. Thank you. Oi. Alrighty. Well, we got this guy. This sketch. Or. Got the lineup for him done. Thank you, Uma. Let me just send a preview. So I'll probably go ahead and end the stream here since it's 7:50. But next stream, which will be this Saturday, I will start on the background and go from there. But thank y'all for joining in today. I hope that you have a wonderful rest of your night and a good rest of your week. And take care. I will see y'all next time. Take care. See ya, everybody.